you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans. This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Hello and welcome to Shawnee High School for today's football matchup between the Shawnee Renegades and the Cherokee Chiefs. I'm Jimmy Freese here with along with Joe Malagrana. And Joe, what can we expect from today's football rivalry game?
Rivalry it is. What a great night for great game. Nothing as good as Cherokee against Shawnee football. Cherokee's coming in a little bit better record. They're ranked. Shawnee is coming in with a 3-2 record. Of course, Cherokee has a 4-2 record. They're coming off a big win against Lenape, undefeated Lenape last week. But both teams have a lot to play for. Cherokee, if they win, they clinch a tie in their division. And Cherokee is looking to keep their playoff hopes alive. Cherokee's led by Evan Powell. Shawnee's led by Michael Welsh. Should be a great game.
All right, thanks, Joe. We look forward to this game. We'll be back for kickoff.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel. 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680. Or by email, jmelagrana@lrhsd.org.
All right, and we're back here.
Tim Welsh, Mike Casey, Kevin Toomey, and Joe Bob Patterson.
We're back here at Shawnee.
Our athletic trainer tonight is Mr. Tim Patterson, as well as Ms. Stephanie Faraz.
And it's now time for the AXA Equitable Keys to the Game, providing millions of customers with life insurance. Right. And it's time for the AXA Equitable Sideline Report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident. At 732-452-7275. And now let's send it over to Alyssa with the report.
Thanks, guys. So I was able to talk to both of the coaches, and they had very different strategies for this season. Cherokee is planning on taking up one game at a time, and Shawnee's goal is to ultimately win another championship. Some Shawnee players to look out for are the quarterback, Mike Welsh, and Anthony Magoo. And Cherokee says to look out for their secondary defense because they've really been working on their throws. Jimmy and Joe, back to you.
Thank you, Alyssa.
Captain, number 56, see, Matt Russo.
The teams go out to midfield.
Number 50, John Tabor. Number 71, Kevin Galt.
And it's now time for the Axe Equitable Keys to the Game, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident. 732-452-7275. And Joe, we're looking at here that Cherokee needs strong field position.
Right, if they start off with good field position, that's half the battle won. And a couple years ago they had a kicker, and I apologize, I forget his name. He just put the other team so far deep in their territory that resulted in a great field position for Cherokee, and that's what they want to see tonight.
And Shawnee must control the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, with their powerful running game the Cherokee has, if they can control that line of scrimmage, should really even things out tonight.
And both teams don't want any turnovers.
No, that's a killer. The free passes to turn the ball over, give them possession. The team usually that doesn't have as many turnovers usually wins the games, we see on our screen now.
Thanks, Joe.
See our captains for tonight, for Shawnee Renegades. It's Kevin Galt, John Tabor, Matt Russo, Anthony Magoo, Michael Welsh, and David Kajarowicz. And for the visiting Chiefs, you have Evan Powell, John Lovett, R.J. Wolf, and Mike Font.
And join Shawnee Jr., Veronica Robertson, in singing.
And Veronica Robertson's going to sing our national anthem for us here.
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
A great job there by Junior Veronica Robinson on our national anthem. And Jimmy, I'm going to clear up one thing. In the pregame, I made a mistake and said that Cherokee was 4-2. Of course, they are 4-1. And I also said that Cherokee was trying to keep their playoff hopes alive. Well, naturally, I was talking about Shawnee with a big victory tonight, picking up a lot of power points. Of course, the Renegades are led by longtime coach Timmy Gushu and former colleague of mine here at Shawnee. He has a current record, comes in today's game with a record of 226 wins, 103 losses, and 3 ties. You see we got Coach Gushu getting ready, his troops ready to come in. Looks like Shawnee's going to be kicking off to the Chiefs.
Joe, 33 years for Tim Gushu, that's quite a bit.
Yeah, and he came in, I started my teaching career here in September 73, and I believe it was the following year he started teaching. He was on the staff, And not too long after that, he became head coach, and he's been here ever since.
Number 36, Richard Demko, ready to kick off for the Renegades here. And he'll kick it. Bounce picked up at about the 16-yard line. And dropped down by the Renegade. Max Buchanan on the tackle.
Can it look like? Okay, look like Ryan Rickards fielded the kickoff on that. And Cherokee is starting off on their own 22-23-yard line.
And like our announcer said, Evan Powell back. He'll run it.
Pretty good yardage on the first down keeper by Evan Powell, number one.
Got a 5-yard gain there. At the 29-yard line.
Gain of 5 yards.
Now Evan Powell through this year does have 3 rushing touchdowns and also 4 passing touchdowns. So he could do it on the ground and also in the air.
And the shotgun, he'll hand it off. Brought down for about a gain of 2 yards. And John Levitt on that run.
Jonathan Levitt on the carry for Cherokee, tackled by number 40, Mike Casey.
All right, that's number 7, John Levitt, who has racked up 440 yards so far this year with 5 touchdowns.
And Evan Powell in the shotgun. 2 men by his side. Hands it off. Oh, and stopped him.
That's going to be close. I'm wondering if we're going to get a measurement here. From our vantage point, looks like he may be a little short.
That'll bring him 4th down.
No need for a measurement. They're going to have to punt it away.
And back to punt. And back to receive is Anthony Magoo. And the punt is away. Magoo fair catches it at the 35-yard line.
And that's field, pretty good field position for the Renegades to start their offensive, their first offensive play here.
And Shawnee led by Mike Welsh here. Likes to run and pass.
Right, because he has 7 passing touchdowns, and he also has 7 rushing touchdowns. He has 793 yards in the air, and he also 367 yards on the ground. So he's also, as Evan Powell, a double threat for this Shawnee offense.
Mike Welsh in the shotgun. He'll keep it. Get a good run for about 8 yards.
About 8 yards, great run to start the game for the Renegades. And Jimmy, of course, Michael Welsh and Evan Powell have been facing each other through the Medford and Marlton program since they were in third grade, so they know each other quite well, and they certainly respect each other.
And Welsh looking for somebody.
Got him
open.
Throws
it down the field.
Oh,
just. And overthrew him a little bit there. Looking for Ant Magoo.
Man. One advantage of being high up, you can see the play develop. You know he had some separation, but unfortunately just a little bit long. Not a bad play call there for second down. Now here at 3rd and 3 right now.
And Welsh in the shotgun with Githens to his side, number 27. Welsh keeps it. And close to a first down.
Welsh again on the quarterback.
That's very close. I see where the spot is. Give him the first down. No need to have those chain gangs run all the way across the field.
Well,
Nice control here. Two run plays. One deep play for incomplete. Shawnee gets the first down of the day.
And number five, Sean Lewandowski comes in. Wide receiver. Welsh in the shotgun. Welsh has it. Looking for somebody. And overthrows him there. Overthrows Davon Robinson.
And Davon was double covered there, and I think he saw that and possibly wanted to keep it away from any possible turnovers. Second down and 10.
Defense, as you said, Joe, is led by R.J. Wolf, the nose guard, and Mike Font, a linebacker. Two captains. And Welsh snaps it. Quick throw. And dropped.
Michael Wilson passed his hand for number 38. Adam Nolan is incomplete.
Adam Nolan couldn't get his hands on it. And third and 10 here for Shawnee.
Third and 10. You wonder if may keep it on the ground here since the last two passes, last two or three passes, I should say, were unsuccessful. They'll be in the shotgun. Little mix up in the formation. Welsh corrects the problem and they're ready to go.
Everybody's out wide here. Welsh. And can't get it. Close play, Michael Johnson.
Yeah, just off his fingertips there and unfortunately, the Renegades are going to have to punt. Started their first offensive possession in good field position, but they have to give it up here. Of course, coming into this game, Cherokee's defense has really been strong all year long, I should say. Defense came up big last week against Lenape.
Number 31, Matt Steuben to punt. Gets it away. An opportunity here.
It's number 16, Ryan Rickards. The great run back after the catch.
Giving his team great field position.
Yeah, talk about the first keys to the game. They certainly successful on this particular punt. They're starting it out on their 47-yard line.
Looks like Jake Bodine's in for quarterback. First play in, that'll get him about 3 yards.
Yeah, and they've been mixing it up all year long between Powell and Bodine.
It's hard for a defense, Joe, to get ready for two quarterbacks.
Right, and both of them have been successful both on the ground and in the air.
And under center, first time we're seeing that out of Cherokee's offense. With Bodine still in. Hands it off. And Lovett stopped, maybe a gain of a yard.
Jonathan Lovett on the carry for Cherokee. Tackle for a loss of one.
And caught it.
Missed tackle there.
And that'll get a first down. And Bodine with a nice pass. Comes in and makes a couple big plays. That's a first down for Cherokee.
Yeah, it was a great second effort there, too. Had a chance. Shawnee had a chance to get the first tackle, missed tackle, and managed to get the first down on the second and third efforts.
We're seeing Bodine stay in. He'll hand it off to Font. Font gains about a yard.
Tried to go right up the middle. Nothing there.
Michael Font on the carry for Cherokee. Tackled by number 21,
Cam Wheatley. Gain of one on the play, brings up second and nine.
Tackled there by number 21, Dan Wigley.
Bodine here. High formation. Hands it off to Lovett. Lovett will get some yards. This is big here. And that's a touchdown right there. Cherokee Chiefs getting on the board first.
Touchdown, Cherokee.
John Lovett.
Where there wasn't much room for him to get through. He got through. Once he got through, he was gone. He was on to the races. Start the first touchdown of the night. Goes to the Chiefs.
Got some blocking from Font there and had it right up the middle pretty much. And that's good for the extra point. That'll put up Cherokee 7-0.
Probably got a replay here by Ivy Rehab.
We're going to show that replay. Let's take a look at that replay, sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy, on the web at ivyrehab.com. Going to be the extra point there.
The extra point. And maybe we'll get the replay of the touchdown run. But in any case, it's 7 points for the Chiefs.
And we know the importance of that 1 point.
Absolutely, yeah. In fact, I think Cherokee this year did miss a couple, two or three extra points. And hopefully they're going to, Coach Megan wanted to solidify that fact and don't want to lose any extra points. That's for sure.
And Coach Megan been coaching at Cherokee for 14 years.
Right, and his career record is 121-32, and he followed Hall of Fame coaches, John Scott.
And we're gonna take another look at a replay, and sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy, on the web at ivyrehab.com. And I think we're gonna see this is the touchdown here. Gets a good block, jukes out a couple guys, and one man to beat, and he had him.
Ooh. Almost had a shot to stop him around the three, but nothing doing. So we got to replay the touchdown and the extra point.
There you go, Joe.
Double your money. And of course, we thank Joe Moore at Ivy Rehab for sponsoring our replay for the fall. Visited many times there with my achy body.
And Welsh alone in the backfield. All men out wide. Welsh steps back. He'll keep it. About a gain of 2 yards.
Yeah, with nobody in the backfield, Cherokee's defense just geared for the pass, forced Michael to run, and managed to pick up 1 or 2 yards. The scoreboard listed as 2nd and 8.
Welsh in the backfield. And hands it off.
There's a flag on the play. We may have a false start here against Shawnee. Backfield in motion, I think.
About a 3 yard gain before the penalty. That run was by Mikey Githens.
There's a penalty marker down. It'll be false start against the Renegades.
That'll bring the Renegades back.
So it's going to look like
2nd and 13, yep, at the 5 yards back.
Brings up 2nd and 13 for the Renegades.
Welsh with Githens by his side. And we have a whistle here on the field.
Our team to victory.
Referees just need to talk something out there. Wells steps back, looking for someone. He's going to keep it and run out of bounds for about a five-yard gain.
Yeah, just past the original line of scrimmage. It comes up with third and maybe six or five.
Out of bounds at the 20-yard line. Brings up third and eight for the Renegades.
Make it better. We're back to third and eight again. Okay.
You were close, John. Right?
Yeah, well.
That's
if it gets past 10, I have to take off my shoes to count. So hopefully that doesn't happen too often.
Welsh in the shotgun. Drops back. And he's got him.
First completion for the Renegades. And that was tight coverage by the Cherokee
Michael
Chiefs.
Welsh,
but
looks like Ant Magoo with that catch.
Great pass there by Michael Welsh to Anthony Magoo.
Shawnee first down. Welsh receives the snap. Running to his left to Magoo. And Magoo's got a nice catch, and that'll be about a 9-yard gain.
Yeah, I think he's going to be a little bit short on the first down, but another down and out by Anthony Magoo on the other side of the field. Keeps the Shawnee, keeps them alive after being buried back in their defensive zone with because of the penalty.
And Joe, Alyssa did say that Anthony Magoo is a player to watch tonight. And
absolutely. That's his main target. That's Welsh's main target. And showing it right now.
Welsh hands it off to Githens. And Githens with a nice run. Good run. And tackled by Billy Bueller. At about the 45-yard line for a first down for Shawnee.
Great handoff there. Pump fake pass the other way. Little bit of daylight and big pickup. As we mentioned earlier, that Mike Givens does have seven touchdowns and also one passing touchdown. A little bit confusion there, and I think Coach Guthrie does not want to interrupt their offensive flow here with another, maybe delay a game or false start, and wisely calls a timeout. That's the first for the Renegades for this first quarter and first half. I mean, before we went to the replay, I was mentioning that Coach P.J. Megan followed legendary Coach John Scott, which unfortunately we lost a couple years ago. And he was the second coach of Cherokee and also the first coach, Jim Horner. If I remember correctly, Coach John Scott played some pro ball for the old Baltimore Colts. I believe he was the backup of Earl Morrow back in the day. Fine gentleman. My kids had him in class at Cherokee High School.
Always some terrific history lesson from you, Joe.
We
really appreciate it.
You get to be 105 like I am, and hopefully you don't forget some things.
And Welsh will go to a wide, wide open. Was Adam Nolan for a first down.
In the last three or four passes, you see more of a quick slant. The two or three that Welsh overthrew were kind of like down in the middle of the field. Maybe they're catching a little bit of weakness there on the side. Not too much weakness in the Cherokee defense, but a little separation, I should say. More on the slam patterns. The quick outs.
Forming a nice little drive here, Joe.
That's it. Good timeout by Coach Guthrie because they were not on the players were not on the same page before the timeout. Now they are.
Welsh with the ball. Hands it off to Githens, who is immediately hit, maybe after 1 yard.
We do have a flag coming in. One of the late hit or face mask. Let's see what we have here. Ah, it's going to go against the Renegades, I believe. That's coming back.
Holding 7-1 offense, 10 yards from the end of the run, repeat first down.
Have the microphones on the refs, that's
Hey, big time.
How about that?
Big time here in South Jersey. Yeah, it's going to be offensive holding on the Renegades. It's going to bring it back 10 yards.
So first and 20 for the Renegades.
Well, they made up for it before. Let's see if they can make up for it again.
Welsh takes the snap, looking for something big. Goes to Magoo. Magoo driving, looking for about a 9-yard gain there.
Welsh is pass complete to Anthony Magoo, number 17.
Now Welsh was looking downfield and went underneath. Magoo was open and got a lot of that yardage back.
See Coach Gush, you're making a couple substitutions each play. Trying to change Cherokee's view up a little bit here.
Cherokee bringing almost everybody up here.
Welsh gets it off. And he's got it!
He's in.
That looks like number 2, Mike Johnson.
We just mentioned that everybody was up for Cherokee. I think they may have been playing for run or possibly a blitz. And well, she picked that up and it just blew right by the defenders. Not too much back there, so if you know he was going to make a catch, he was gone and have a chance to tie up the score.
Nice catch by Michael Johnson and nice throw by Michael Welsh. And on to kick the field goal here is Richard Demko for the PAT. Demko will knock it in.
We have a tie score.
Shawnee, after being penalized, we're going to... Let's take a look at that replay, sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy. On the web at ivyrehab.com. And Joe, let's see this touchdown one more time.
Looks like we're just going to catch the end of it, but that's okay. As long as he crosses the goal line, Shawnee ties up Cherokee here 7-7 with 1 minute and 3 seconds left in the first quarter. Just great, great football so far.
After being penalized, Shawnee comes back, two plays, gets a touchdown. And Demko on to kick it away.
See if Cherokee can get another good field position on this kickoff, as they did in the last punt.
Received at about the 18. Nice run back yet again.
Yeah, around the 37.
That looks like Ryan Rickards.
Right, Ryan number Rickards receiver. Again, number 16, yep.
Run it back to the 42-yard line.
37. It's okay. We're going the other way.
And back in the pocket.
His pal's back in. He's going to be
sacked. Pressure and Powell is sacked.
Quarterback sacked by number 50, John Tabor.
John Tabor bringing him down.
All right, and Powell had what they call the old coverage sack, where there's no place to throw the ball. It's too late to get any kind of run going, so resulted in the first sack by the Renegades. Brings them back second and 18.
And Powell alone in the backfield. Love it in motion. And the ball's on the ground. And Powell picks it up, and it's going to be another loss of yards.
Oh, they were lucky there. That wasn't a turnover. That would have been unbelievable field position for the Renegades. Fortunately, Cherokee got it back up. Yeah. I think Cherokee may be calling a timeout here, picking up their first timeout.
Coach Megan's probably telling everybody to calm down. We're going to look at the replay. Sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com. We'll take a look. Powell picks up the drop.
I think that was the sack probably before the drop sack.
Russo with terrific pressure.
Okay, there's no timeout call. It was the end of the quarter. So Cherokee still has their three timeouts for the first half, and Shawnee did use one, so they have two left for the first half. It's great football so far, very interesting, 7-7 tie.
Joe, as we were saying, Coach Megan trying to get his guys in order, calm down a little bit.
Right, and they've been around so long and worked together for so long that they're not going to get flustered. Defensive coordinator Matt Schultz really has his defense working, and I'm sure he'll be making some adjustments to counteract this. So far, a pretty powerful offense by the Renegades.
So Powell, with Lovett by his side, hands it off to Lovett. Lovett will be stopped almost immediately for a gain of a yard, or a loss of a yard. Matt Russo with two straight big plays.
So far, the Renegades have stopped their run game, which is a big part of the Cherokee offense.
Still going to be punt. Fourth and 22. Magoo and Githens back to receive.
They should have good field position here, Jim. Great kick.
And Magoo fair catches it.
They start at their own 45. Great field position to start the second quarter.
Anthony Magoo with the fair catch.
Ball is fired. Three and out forced by Shawnee.
Shawnee, 45-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Renegades.
Their senior Michael Welsh wearing the infamous number 45 for the Renegades in honor of way back eighth grader Nick Garner, who was a football player ready to come into Shawnee and fortunately succumbed to a terrible disease. The number 44 is worn by one player every year. It excels on and off the field, and certainly Michael Welsh deserves that honor.
Welsh will hand it off to Githens. Githens for another good gain of about 5 yards. Joe, I think Shawnee really, after 2013 and 2014, South Jersey Group 5 champions. I mean, that's pretty big.
Cherokee, yeah. Cherokee,
yes, Cherokee.
Group 5, right? And, about, I guess, 5 or 6 years ago, there was no really Group 5, but the enrollment at Shawnee, of course, along with like Lenape and Washington Township, that the enrollment was so big that they made a new group for them.
Welsh in the backfield will take it himself. Diving into that.
Powers his way, possibly picking up a first down.
Gonna have to see where it's placed. Might be shorter yard.
Yeah, from here it looks short. Well, it depends where they're going. I think they're going to have a measurement.
Maybe bring out the chain gang for the first time.
Looks a little short. Yeah, it looks a little short from here, because right where we're sitting, we're almost right on the line, so we don't have a bad angle, and it is short.
A third and about one, maybe inches, pretty much. Three receivers on one side. Close to the line here. Welsh hands it off to Githens, who will get the first down with about a gain of 5 yards.
And then some. Moving the chains, and they're moving again.
First down for Shawnee. Cherokee's 42-yard line. First time seeing Welsh under center tonight. Giffen's behind him. And got a whistle.
Probably false start.
Probably.
On the Renegades, yep.
Send him back 5 yards.
Fraction offense, 5 yard penalty, repeat first down.
Well, last two possessions, Shawnee has dug out of the hole on some of the penalties, see if they can do it again.
And Welsh back in the shotgun. Giffen's by his side. Hands it off to Giffen's. Will regain the yards. Got the penalty. Put him back at it. Should be a second down. And 9. Welsh alone in the backfield. Welsh gets the snap. Quick throw to Giffen's. Giffen's puts a couple moves. It'll get him about 5 yards.
Interesting to see on this third down play if Cherokee is going to have most of the team up like they had last time, but resulted in the long touchdown pass by Shawnee.
So third down and 5.
Yeah, they're going to keep some people back. They don't mind giving up some short yardage here.
Well, snaps it, keeps it, and he'll get another first down and more. And Welsh will take it down to the 24-yard line.
It's a great job done by the Renegades offensive line here. Created a big opening for Michael Welsh. Picks up a big first down.
Welsh alone in the backfield. Welsh, again another quick pass to Giffen's. And a tackle.
Welsh is passing number 27.
About 3 yard gain.
Tackled by number 27, Steven Gervasi.
Tackled by Gervasi, number 27.
Yeah, last time when that play managed to pick up a few extra yards, this time Gervasi didn't let him go.
Gervasi is a sophomore, or a junior, and he is a returning starter.
He's also tight end with 7 catches and 1 touchdown on the year.
Welsh in the backfield. He's going to keep it, but gets stopped immediately by Gervasi and
Mike Tobin, I believe, number 22, yeah.
Welsh in the backfield. Alone. Cherokee's got their coverage set. Welsh will keep. No, he'll throw it. and get hit immediately. Hard hit on Mike Givens, but pops right up. Good to see he's all right.
And from up here, you can see that there wasn't much to run up the middle. Michael Walsh looked like he decided he was going to take the run, and Mike Givens is waving his hands that he was open, and fortunately he caught him last second, and he took a hit, but he also got a big big gain.
Let's take a look at that replay sponsored by Ivy Rehab. Physical therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
I think we're live here. Maybe we'll get that replay in a second.
After this play, maybe. Welsh keeps it. Or a gain of about a yard.
Well, it's ahead on the quarterback keeper. Tackled by number 27, Stephen Girassi.
Girassi with another tackle.
Gain of one.
Mike Johnson coming back in, who scored the last touchdown for the Renegades. Maybe going to look for him again. .430 to go here in the second quarter. And there's a whistle and another timeout for Shawnee.
We have a timeout charge to the Renegades, their second.
Yeah, it's called by Tim Gushue and the Renegades. That's their second timeout. They have one remaining.
He's not afraid to use their timeouts.
No, if he doesn't, four minutes left, why not? Maybe we'll see the touchdown or the big play here.
We're going to look at that replay. Sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy.
I started the run. Not much there. Giffen's open, but takes a big hit. But after big yardage gained by the Renegades. Well, Jim, last time the Renegades called the timeout, they went on to tie the score. Let's see if they take advantage of their timeout, getting everybody on the same page, see if they could take the lead here.
We'll see. As I said, Mike Johnson back, and we'll see if he's used again. Magoo also on the field with Githens. Maybe trying to catch Cherokee off sides there.
Almost got him to jump, but he got back and didn't cross the plane.
And Welsh will take the snap.
Oh, looking for got it right back.
How about that right there? And that is it. Oh, my goodness.
Just ready to say batted down by the Chiefs, but
Lord.
I saw the ball went right back to Michael Welsh. And
he puts it right. What a play.
I tell you, Coach Gush is going to ask for five timeouts per half.
Yet again, a timeout and a score right after. What a play. We're going to look at that replay, Joe. Unbelievable play. Let's take a look at that. Sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy and on the web at ivyrehab.com. So it's tipped, and Welsh actually gets it back. And Richard Demko puts the icing on the cake.
14-7
lead. 14-7.
Well, when you're good, creates the luck. A lot of times, the luck makes you good. Part of the game, and again, fortunately for the Cherokee Chiefs, they know they have plenty of time left here. Get back into this game. This next possession is going to be important because they certainly don't want to give the ball up, and they certainly don't want to give up any more points before halftime.
I believe Shawnee is getting the ball after halftime, too.
That's right. They started the game. They kicked it off to the Chiefs. You're absolutely right. So this is really important here. With 4:14 left in the second quarter, the Chiefs do not give up any points, and hopefully they get the ball back and break down into that lead that Shawnee has right now with 7 points, 14-7.
Richard Demko to kick it away.
They're going to get good field possession once again.
Ryan Rickards on that return. looking at the 38.
Yep.
Ryan Rickard on the kick return to Cherokee. Tackled by number 42, Will King. Ball is spotted at the Cherokee 38 yard line.
I think we're looking at Powell back in the game. No.
Now that's Bodine, yep.
Yeah.
Threw it off to John Lovett, picked up a couple.
Jonathan Lovett on the carry, tackled by showing number 69, David the Gatorovich.
David Gatorovich on that tackle, a big impact since his freshman year, starting every year since then. Unbelievable force on the line there for Shawnee. Second down and 8. Hands it off to Lovett. Lovett will be stopped for a gain of about 2.
About 3rd and 5 is a big third down play here for the Chiefs. Keep this thing going.
Good for a gain of 2, brings up 3rd and 6.
All right, and we see Bodine in the shotgun by himself. Trips to the left.
Oh, I don't
think that might have hit the ground, Joe.
It looked like it hit the ground here, but even if it didn't, I don't think there's any gain on the play.
Referees called it a catch.
Okay.
But
4th and 6, going to have to punt it away.
Bodine's pass is complete to number 9, Michael Ballard.
Cherokee yet again. Three and out. A good punt. Wow.
Yeah, very good punt. Only to do with a fair caught.
Fair caught at the 25.
25 yard line.
Still plenty of time to get this ball back for Cherokee if they can give him a quick three and out. Of course, Shawnee wants to, extend their possession here. Even if they don't score, they wouldn't mind, I'm sure, going into the locker room with a 7-point lead.
From Gushue, getting his troops together. See what Shawnee has to offer and what Cherokee comes back with. Are being scored on 2 straight times. So Shawnee's really trying to go for a hard count there, trying to catch the Chiefs offsides.
Looks like they may be changing up this play from the formation, and I think Coach Gushue is going to use that third timeout.
And we'll see if
yes
stays true to form if he scores a touchdown after this timeout. Got quite a long way to go, but
as I mentioned, he's going to be on the rules change committee to add a few more timeouts per half.
So as we're looking at the Shawnee, their weak points were inexperience at certain positions, Joe. Hasn't showed too much tonight.
No, that's for sure. Maybe their inexperience, their 2 losses were fairly early in the season, so possibly the inexperience and whatever those positions were very general, the comment. Maybe they had that ironed out and just experience, under their belt. And again, they're fully rested coming off of a bye week, too. And Cherokee had a hard-fought, victory against Lenape last week.
Of course, Shawnee losing Jake Parola last year, star running back, who's attending Widener, I think. And Welsh back, throws to Githens. Githens will run out of bounds.
A little late hit there and
by Lovett,
but no flag.
Referee's going to let him, maybe this game may get a little chippy here, Joe.
Well, he wanted to get out of bounds to stop that clock, and he managed to do that.
It's going to bring a 2nd down and 1. up for Shawnee. With Welsh in the backfield, Githens to his right. Welsh, the same play. And
why not? Why not? It's been working, and I'm sure Cherokee is, you know, playing a little bit back to prevent the big play.
Tackled by Mike Font.
Especially with 2 minutes and 6 seconds left in the second quarter.
Welsh. Gets the snap. There's a blitz. Cherokee.
Picked up.
Welsh is going to throw it down to a wide open Mike Johnson, who will bring it down at the 38-yard line.
And managed to get out of bounds and stop the clock. I think it was only like maybe 6-7 seconds knocked off the clock there. We're at like 1:58 right now.
Cherokee 38-yard line,
it'll be first and 10
for the Renegades.
At the Cherokee 38,
first and 10. Keeping the foot on the pedal, Shawnee is. Welsh gets a snap. Looking for somebody. To Johnson again. He'll catch it for another first down.
And out of bounds.
And there's a flag here. Well, could be coming back. Referee's talking about it.
I think it's going to be coming back. An eligible man downfield, yeah. I believe.
Yeah, it's 56 downfield.
The penalty will be illegal receiver downfield.
That's exactly what the call is. It's going to come back.
Time is stopped.
Ineligible receiver downfield, 56 offense, 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
That is a 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
And that's a tough play, probably. You know, thought he was going to run and then go down the block and winds up passing. Probably just broke a little bit too early. Got called for the penalty.
Giffen's on the side of Welsh. Welsh looking for somebody. Gets hit from the back.
It looked like
we were trying to go for a catch, and it's incomplete.
Yeah, he got hammered on that play, almost a sack. And
Welsh comes up limping, actually, a little bit limp.
And even though it was a flutter pass because of the pressure, Shawnee almost had another completion, kind of on a busted play. He's gingerly walking back to the huddle. Looks like he's okay.
Good to see.
Well, the incompletions keep the clock stopped anyway. With 1:42, get a replay.
Let's take
here.
A look at that replay. Sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy on the web at ivyrehab.com.
Outside, just as he's ready to release, and oh, it was almost a completion. We didn't get to see it there, but almost a completion on the busted play.
So Welsh with the drop back.
And a screen, a lot of room.
Look at this. First down. Wow. Mike Githens out there looking a little bit like Darren Sproles, Joe.
And a great call on, looked like two people blitzing from the outside on Cherokee.
Darren Sproles or Shane Vereen, whatever team you cheer for.
I'll take Sproles.
Hopefully Sproles.
Oh, yeah.
And there's Welsh.
Scoreboard.
Two. That's the first time we're seeing Davon Robinson with a catch.
Davon Robinson. Tackle by number two, Connor Ashton. 9-yard gain.
So seeing the scoreboard, the time is running down. Welsh drops back. And he's got it. Wow! That's another touchdown for the Renegades. And who we have. That was Adam Nolan on the catch. So Welsh spreading it around.
Yeah, spreading the wealth around. Big score just before the end of the second quarter.
Touch the pass.
touchdown reception by number 38, Adam Nolan.
Quick possession there, Joe. And Demko, we'll put the icing on the cake right there, 21-7.
And I don't think there was a run play in that whole offensive possession. I don't remember one anyway. It was a screen pass and mostly deep passes, down and out. Here's the replay.
Going to look at the replay, sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy, on the web at ivyrehab.com. That was the play before the touchdown.
Okay, that was the setup play to
Davon
Robinson, yep. In any case, 21 unanswered points by the Renegades here after a quick score to open in the game, early in the game, I should say, by the Chiefs.
Adam Nolan having the strength to keep that in while defended.
Just pinpoint passing up and down the field by Michael Welsh.
And here goes Demko's kick. With 51 seconds to go.
Yeah, we thought there was going to be like kind of on the ground a short punt. Didn't want to risk a big run back here. And they're getting the ball at the 38. And they have been getting the ball around the 38 even with the deep kickoff. So some interesting strategy here by Coach Gushue.
So maybe we can see Cherokee march down the field as Shawnee did. With 48 seconds to go.
48 seconds left. Shawnee has everybody up here.
Powell, who stay in the game, will get in the game, and he's going to lose about 4 yards.
Yeah, interesting call here to keep it on the ground. Probably won't see much now with the clock running with 30 seconds. They certainly don't want to throw it up in the air, risk a turnover and an interception.
23 seconds to go.
Well, of course, they're going to throw it. And they're throwing it deep.
Powell drops back and overthrows number 82, Nick Mofa. With 14 seconds to go in this first half, which was mainly controlled by Shawnee's offense.
Right, and Moffitt really didn't have any kind of separation there anyway. But it did stop the clock, and maybe we'll see what Coach Megan does here with 14 seconds. Probably, most likely the last play of the half, especially if they keep it on the ground. Big third and 13.
Powell will keep it. We'll run it. Heading toward out of bounds.
That's nice. A first down and then some. It's out of bounds when stops the clock with 6 seconds left. Of course, they still have the three timeouts. But with 6 seconds left, probably not much of an opportunity unless they get a really quick big play here and call a very, very quick timeout with 6 seconds left.
Between the Shawnee 46 and the 47. Powell's biggest run this game. And it looks like we're going to have a timeout for Cherokee.
That's their first half and the half. They have two left, but again, with only 6 seconds left in the first half. Shawnee with a big 21-7 lead.
Caroline Torley, Jeff Morelli, Millie Carbone, and Jacqueline Scott. Your Shawnee Cheers!
See Cherokee trying to get together here, see what they can come up with just 6 seconds left and two timeouts. Down by 14.
So we see that Cherokee had 31 seniors graduate last year.
Yeah, well, one of the good things of being a Group 5 school is they have a lot of bodies to fill in spots, and they've done that quite well this year.
Powell, big pass, and will not get there. His receiver.
That's going to do it for the first half. They went for the
big play.
Well, they have to lose with the, you know, if it gets intercepted, probably not going to have a big run.
21,
But in any case, a big, big first half for the Shawnee Renegades. Just mostly done in the air. As you see on your screen right now, Shawnee with a big 21-7 lead at halftime.
Terrifically possessed by Shawnee. And we're going to take a break here. We'll see you back for the second half. And we're going to talk, we're going to see our sponsors here. And we'll see you for the second half.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market, all the best, all right here. 215-336-3003, or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel. 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford. 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680. Or by email, jmelagrana@lrhsd.org.
If you suspect your teen is using a cell phone to connect to drugs, don't ignore the signs. Go to the partnership at drugfree.org.
Each year, innocent people fall victim to the dangers of distracted driving. Nearly 50% of teens admit to texting while driving. As long as there are distracted drivers on our roads, anyone can become a victim. Don't make someone else a statistic. Heads up, eyes forward. For more information and to see what happens next, visit www.lrhsd.org/heads up.
Isn't a kid having a pet wild boar a rite of passage?
Sure. We experimented with omnivorous swine as teenagers, right?
Maybe we should get some help.
Oh, what would the neighbors say?
Some things can't wait. If your teen is trying drugs, you can do something about it.
I bet it's just a phase.
Yeah.
Ooh. Find out more from the partnership and our community partners.
And we're back here at Shawnee High School, coming back from halftime.
Jim, while we're waiting for a sideline report, just a fine rendition by the Shawnee band here with Nick Rotundo, the band director. Little Marcel Marceau flavor. Also, ooh, a little Furco string band flavor from 1986.
Nice.
Mime theme from the Furco band. Of course, I played with the dad in Furco. Here we have the sideline report coming
up. It's now time for the AXA Equitable sideline report, providing millions of customers with life insurance, annuities, and other needs-based products since 1859. AXA Equitable, be life confident. That's 732-452-7275. And let's send it over to Alyssa for the report.
Thanks, guys. So I was only able to talk to Coach Gashu from Shawnee, and he said that to keep the lead, they're just going to keep doing what they've been doing, which is blocking, running, just the normal
Renegades
game plan. And we'll just have to see what Cherokee's plan is. Thanks, guys. Back to you.
Thank you, Alyssa.
Well, Jim, while we were on that sideline report, Cherokee opened with an onside kick. It looked like up here that they recovered it, but apparently didn't have control, and Shawnee picks up the onside kick and gets it on their own 38 throw to start. They get the ball and great field position.
So back with Mike Welsh in the shotgun. Move a little bit, gets hit as he throws.
Ooh.
Magoo covered by two men.
Mike Welsh got hammered, just got that off, and almost a completion in between, double team. Number 17,
Anthony Magoo.
The Shorty's coming out firing. They said they want to keep the pressure on, as the sideline reporter mentioned. They want to keep what they're doing. It's worked so far. Why change?
I want to see how Coach Megan comes at the Renegades offense after halftime. What he told his guys.
Well, he took a chance with the onside kick. It looks like we're going to get a false start against the Renegades again. Yep, it's going to come back 5 yards.
I think in an attempt to get the defense to go offsides, the offensive line had a little miscommunication there to drop him back 5 yards.
Yeah, and plus, since Michael Welsh almost got sacked on that previous play, looks like Matt Schultz, the defensive coordinator of the Chiefs, are really going to turn up the heat defensively. See if they can get some turnovers and get back into this ball game.
Second and 15 here for the Renegades. Nobody in the backfield with Welsh. Welsh dropping back. Throws it to Johnson.
That pass is, that play's been working all day, Jim.
Johnson, who was the first Renegade to score a touchdown tonight. We're going to be looking at 3rd and 5 here. Joe, as you said it, that play has been working most of the night.
A third down on a short 5.
Well, Straub's back. Throws to Magoo for a first down for the Renegades across the 50-yard line.
Great pass there. Put it where the only person to get that ball was Anthony Magoo, and Anthony Magoo with those great hands picks up the first down.
We see Adam Nolan coming to the game, who had a touchdown, the third touchdown for the Renegades, to make it 21-7. See if he can make another difference here. Welsh will hand it off to Githens, who will be stopped for about a no gain there.
Yeah, maybe possibly loss of half a yard. They certainly haven't had many running plays, and when they do run up the middle, Cherokee is seem to be stopping for the most part the run right up the middle. They've been successful in a lot of down and out patterns, some play action, some keepers by Welsh himself. So they've been mixing it up, but for now anyway, that run right up the middle doesn't seem to be happening so far.
Welsh in the backfield gets Githens, who will get about 2 yards. Welsh again hit as he throws it.
Gets back maybe a couple yards past the original line of scrimmage. It's going to be 3rd and 8.
Coach Tim Welsh, Mike Welsh's
father and Tim Gushue giving orders on the sideline.
Yeah, before this year was Michael Welsh was the son of Tim Welsh. Now it's Tim Welsh is the father of Michael Welsh. Success.
And Mike throws to an open Anthony Magoo, who will bring it down to the Cherokee 30.
Cherokee's really having a tough time stopping the pass. The aerial game by the Renegades are really clicking tonight.
So at the Cherokee 28, Welsh will hand it off to Githens. And Githens will get down to the, I think the 18-yard line, maybe more.
By number 44, Michael Font. Gain of 10, good for Sony, first down.
And they're still moving that ball, this time on the ground.
Possession so far has been about 3 minutes. Mike Welsh gets the snap, hands it off to Githens. There's a flag on the play after he gains about three.
Yeah, that may be coming back, possible offensive holding.
Tackle by number eight, there is a penalty.
Seven.
Yeah, I believe it's a holding penalty right here against the Renegades. Going to come back.
Locking the back. Number two offense. Ten
That's
for the
I
flag.
Can I stand correct? There's a block in the back.
Ball will be flat attack at the 29-yard line.
It's going to bring the ball back to the 29-yard line.
First down and 20 for the Renegades. Hasn't seemed to be too much of an issue tonight, though.
And this time, Tim Gushue is not calling the timeout. Yeah. Not just yet.
Maybe in a play or two. Welsh will keep it.
Ooh, almost
made one man miss.
Yeah, almost missed a tackle on one.
Number 53 will get that tackle.
Andrew Cardinale, sophomore.
Gain of four on the play.
Should be second and 16 for the Renegades. Second and 18. Welsh drops back with a lot of pressure on him. Had to get rid of it quickly. Looking for Magoo, but...
Yeah, there was two or three Chiefs on him with the blitz and didn't have much time to really even set his feet. That's why he couldn't get a good throw on. Resulting in incomplete pass. Third and 18 here. It's a big play here for both teams. Of course, Shawnee looking to extend this offensive drive, and Cherokee's looking for it to stop it and get that ball back.
Welsh, lone man in the backfield. Gets a snap, drops back to Anthony Magoo. Won't be enough.
No, it's going to be about third and seven, third and five.
Fourth and six.
It's going to be an interesting call here by Coach Gushue. Is he going to try for the field goal? Yeah,
Mike Welsh
is
the
in there. They're going to try to pick up the first down, which is probably the right call.
And here's Welsh, drops back, and won't get it. Mike Johnson was open.
Yeah, just out of the reach of Mike Johnson. That's what Cherokee wanted. They wanted a quicker start, naturally, but still got plenty of time left.
So this could be a big momentum boost for Cherokee. They could march down the field, put some points on the board.
So far, other than that first or second drive by Cherokee early in the game, and Shawnee defense has been there.
Bodine with the toss gets flat around, and that looks like Michael Casey.
Yeah, almost a turnover there, and then you thought he was going to pick up some of the rounds, but that strong Shawnee defense had nothing doing.
That'll put it Cherokee at their own 4-yard line.
I believe that was Jonathan Lovett that had bobbled the ball a little bit and couldn't break the Shawnee.
The throw was a little bit behind. The toss was a little bit behind Lovett. Might have been a little tough for him to get it. We see Bodine looking for a pass. He'll get hit right away, and
two or three Shawnee Renegades with a sack.
Quarterback sack by number 46, Jax Lozinski.
Jax Lozinski.
Ryan Parrish.
Grandson of Greg Lozinski, the famous Phillies baseball player. And that'll put Cherokee at their own 2.
I was wondering if it was the son, but I know the daughter had gone here when I was still teaching here about 20 years ago. So I'm thinking the daughter was here at Shawnee. The son went to Holy Cross.
And here is Cherokee. Their back's pinned. Trying to get something. Nice throw.
Okay, picked up some of the yardage. Still got a long way to go.
Looked like he was going.
The pass complete. The number 27, Steven Gervaisi.
Gervaisi makes another catch. Actually, maybe his first catch of the night. And here comes a punt from Cherokee. Shawnee forcing another 3-and-out. And the punt is off.
Fair catch.
Mike Githens' fair catch is at about the 50-yard line.
Starting another offensive position, this time midfield.
Joe, we said a key to the game for Shawnee was to control the line of scrimmage, and I think they really have, especially in this third quarter, but yeah, the whole first half they did that too.
Their defense has just been phenomenal this entire game. I said other than the fairly quick score, and I think it was Cherokee's second possession of the first quarter. Really not much done by the Chiefs. Shawnee defense been really, really solid tonight.
Michael Welsh will keep the ball. It gets stopped for maybe a loss of a yard. No, we'll stay there.
Yeah, 50-yard line. Might have just got back to the line of scrimmage.
Tackle by number 8, Dylan Kelso.
No game on the play. Shawnee really having a big chunk of the possession, or the possession, time of possession here in this quarter so far. Wells to Magoo. Magoo's going to power for a first down.
And Anthony Magoo has such great hands, because ball was led just maybe a couple inches. You thought it was going to be deflected, but Magoo with his great hands and pulls it in.
And Welsh. Himself. For the hard count, trying to get
Cherokee off. And Welsh drops back.
Wide open.
To a wide open. That's a touchdown for the Renegades.
Touchdown!
Wow.
Looks like Cherokee brought the house again and quick release, wide open.
Looks like another touchdown.
Renegade touchdown pass from Michael Welsh to number 38, Adam Nolan.
Adam Nolan with second his one. Second touchdown of the day.
They're really spreading the aerial attack around.
Yes, they have, Joe.
Looking for the 28th point on the extra point here.
A
28-7 lead. And let's take a look at that replay. Brought to you by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy. On the web at ivyrehab.com.
See Cherokee bringing the house here. Quick release, wide open downfield. Nolan.
That's our setup
okay,
play there.
Setup play.
To Anthony Magoo.
They faked this out again.
The Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy replay.
Well, hold on to that thought and see if we get that replay on that touchdown. In any case, 28-7. I don't think anybody expected this point in time in this game right now to have a 28-7 lead by either team, really. Even all the newspapers that made predictions, majority of them thought that Cherokee would come out a winner, but a very, 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 very close game. Right now, it's certainly anything but.
Demko, the kick. A little squib there. That looks like Rickards. Yeah, Ryan Rickards.
Yeah, he's starting on the 45.
And then, Joe, another key to the game was Cherokee to find. They wanted to find strong field position, and they've been getting that.
They've been getting it, but they haven't been able to do much with it. So maybe that's what the thinking is with Coach Gushue, to do the squib kick instead of kicking it deep. Let's see if they can go three and out here.
And there's Powell.
Wide
for
open.
A big pass, and this could be at the 10, at the 5. Stopped at about the 5-yard line. Powell comes in, one pass, and big game.
Well, they certainly took advantage of the field position on that play.
Cherokee pass play to number 16, Ryan Rickards.
Ryan Rickards been
down to the 25-yard line.
Even though score doesn't show it, Ryan Rickards has been providing for this Cherokee.
Yeah, he's been involved in a lot of their big plays so far, absolutely.
And here comes, looks like, Powell still in,
yeah.
Giving it to Lovett. And down to the 4-yard line. Terrific play, but really have to punch it in. Can't settle for 3 points here, Joe.
No, but it all depends on the situation. See what they can't pick up the first down, so they're going to have to go in.
And a fake pass.
Oh,
and
wide open.
Wide open. Number 27.
Steve Gervasi.
Gervasi from Evan Powell. There it is right there. And a quick Cherokee touchdown. Silence in the crowd here at Shawnee High School.
Yeah, we got that squib kick. Give him midfield possession, almost midfield possession. And, well, Chiefs took advantage of it, that's for sure. That's a big play.
Point after attempt is good by number 31.
We have 2 minutes left in the third quarter. You get the full fourth quarter left. But Cherokee's going to have to stop that aerial attack and by Shawnee to get back into this game, although they did take seven off right here. breaking into that lead. Be interesting to see when Shawnee gets the ball if they're still going to be throwing it in the air majority of the time.
Maybe run it a little bit.
Maybe a little bit
eat
more,
away the
but
time.
But you know, unless they're getting stopped, they're still not being able to stop the Shawnee's aerial attack right now. So it'll be interesting to see what kind of play calling they have here. Certainly don't want to give up any more quick points. Get these strong Cherokee Chiefs squad some confidence going into the fourth quarter.
Cherokee kicks it away.
Another onside.
Small kick, and that was caught by Shawnee. What a heads-up play.
Right, and I don't think if Cherokee received that, I don't think it went to 10 yards anyway, but it doesn't matter because Shawnee got the ball. Matt Russo.
Very heads-up play there. And gives Shawnee terrific field position here.
Yeah, two. It's kind of odd. The two started the quarter or the half, second half with an onside kick, and comes right back with another one.
Could come back to bite him here, though.
Well,
it did the possession before.
I know. I said most of the time the Chiefs are unable to stop the Shawnee offense here. Interesting call.
Welsh will keep it. Oh, for a first down and barrels through. What a hit.
Michael Wells, Shawnee quarterback, keeper.
Almost picks up the first down. He picks up 9 yards on that keeper.
Down to the Cherokee 39-yard line. That is a gain of 9.
Wow.
Quick 9 yards right there, Jeff.
Just an all-around great game by Michael Welsh here tonight.
No interceptions.
Did it on the ground, did it in the air. He's been doing that all year long.
Big night for him. I'll hand it off to Githens, who will get a first down. And about 2 or 3 yards.
Yeah, it wasn't much on the right side. He changed directions and managed to pick up the first ground. First down, excuse me.
Mike Johnson comes into play. Here comes another infamous timeout from Tim Gushue.
Yep, and again, it's just the same reason. It looked like some confusion on the field. With a 14-point lead, he takes one of their three timeouts in the second half. Of course, he used all of them in the first half and usually scored after he called the timeout, so we'll see what happens here.
Ball at the Cherokee 36-yard line.
And while we have the timeout, we'd like to recognize the other coaches at Shawnee High School. Of course, you have head coach Tim Gushue. You also have Brian Bolin, Ryan Blazik, Gene Schulman, Tony Escudero, who's the Dean Martin of Shawnee High School, Tim Welsh, Mike Welsh's dad, the Bullman, Steve Suriano, Luke Bonus, Kyle Rogers, Joe Patterson, Joe Majarowicz, and Bud Kay. And of course, you have the motivational coach, Mr. Kevin Toohey, who is a rock on the outside and a feather on the inside. And we'll mention the Cherokee Chiefs coaching staff in a second.
57 seconds left in the third quarter. And there's Welsh. Gonna look for some action. And there's a flag here.
Like a busted play, and there's a flag in the backfield.
Looks like holding.
Yeah, it's coming back.
Andrew Cardinale, but there is a county marker down.
Got the call from the referee in a little bit.
Holding 60. Offense. 10 from the flag. Still one.
Yeah, I can see from up here. Almost looked like a tackle. And the first time it was a busted play after a timeout. But nonetheless, it's 49 seconds, a little under 50 seconds left in the third quarter.
First and 20.
It is still first down.
Long way to go.
Welsh. Oh, just dropped. Long by Mike Johnson.
Just incomplete out of the hands of number two, Mike Johnson.
Bring up second and 20.
And on that play, I thought the ball was geared toward Anthony Magoo, and I thought, oh my God, he's overthrown, it's going to be a pick. But then number two, again, was back in there and almost had it. It's Michael Johnson.
Welsh with an empty backfield besides himself here. Welsh looking for something big and can't get it. To Adam Nolan.
This is going to be a big stop here for Cherokee and a real confidence booster. Yeah, the clock stopped here.
21 seconds. Joe, another key to the game was for both teams. Neither team wanted to have turnovers, and so far, neither team has.
Okay, they're readjusting the clock here. That's why a little extra time here. Our scoreboard has 22.4 seconds. See if they're going to readjust it anymore. That'd be 30 seconds. We adjusted to 30 seconds left on the clock. Third and 26. It'll be a big stop for the Chiefs here.
Third and 26. Drop back, bringing the house. Oh. And he caught it! Mike Johnson turns around and catches it.
Mike Welsh just stayed in the pocket, got hammered again, went to pass it a back shoulder, and Mike Johnson makes a great catch and moves the chains. Unbelievable play by the Renegades.
Third and 26. They get a first down out of that. And that just symbolizes the kind of night that Shawnee's had tonight.
They're going to let the clock run out. Shawnee's going to have great position in the red zone to start the fourth quarter. Unbelievable play by the Renegades. And the beating that Michael Welsh has been taking, because Cherokee has been bringing the house.
Wow.
Let's take a look at that replay, sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy. And on the web at ivyrehab.com. So, Joe, we see this replay. Mike Welsh gets hit, and Mike Johnson turns around. Gets tackled at about the 18-yard line.
Right. Like I said, I thought the play was actually closer to a sack than I thought, but the Cherokee Chief was low on him, so that freed his throwing arm was free, and he got off a great back shoulder pass. Beautiful play by the Renegades. Well, we do have the time. I did want to mention all of the coaching staff also for the Cherokee Chiefs. I have, head coach P.J. Meegan, defensive coordinator Matt Schultz, defensive line, and special teams coordinator Ryan Walsh, linebacker coach Dan Haverstick, defensive end coach and also one of the freshman coaches, James Geisler, offensive line coach Brian Glatz, wide receivers coach Sean DeVise, and Steve Dolores, the running back coach and also the head freshman coach. Those guys deserve a heck of a lot of credit. Great coaching staff on both teams.
First play here.
Keeper.
Well, she'll keep it for about 5-yard gain.
Play well from the quarterback keeper.
It'll be looking at about second and.
There's three up on the scoreboard, so it doesn't look that doesn't look like three.
Maybe seven.
Yeah,
six.
Probably picked up three on the play.
Mike Welsh with Kithens next to him. Dropping back for a pass. And Magoo gets, he's in. Wow. Anthony Magoo for a touchdown. Joe, that may be his first one tonight.
Yeah, you're right, absolutely right. They're having difficulty stopping the aerial attack here by the Renegades. Wow.
Everything for Shawnee tonight is working.
Points, 35 to 14. Big lead now by Shawnee.
Joe, very
uncharacteristic of Cherokee,
yes,
to give so many
rare
points up. Absolutely.
Especially only at the beginning of the fourth quarter.
I know. We mentioned something like that in the beginning of the game where, especially last week's game, as we're told, it was a defensive display of power by Cherokee to defeat undefeated Lenape last week. Unbelievable. Michael Welsh is certainly getting the ball off quick, resulting in a lot of completions tonight.
Definitely spreading the wealth tonight.
This time they kick it a little deeper, or they're still going to have good field position. Almost in midfield.
Yeah, let's take a look at that replay of the touchdown sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy at the web at ivyrehab.com. Michael Welsh looking for a little bit, finds Magoo. Magoo fight.
2-3 seconds, Magoo crossing in the middle. With the height and his great hands, pinpoint accuracy by Michael Welsh resulted in yet another Shawnee touchdown.
Evan Powell will keep it. Yeah, looking about second and five or four. Five. There's Powell. And his throw will hit the ground.
And even if that was incomplete, okay. Couldn't tell because his back was to us. Even if it was a completed pass, he's down and no gain. Actually, it would have been a loss. It was a completion.
So it looks like the same formation. Powell. Keep it. And looks like he should get the first down.
I think he's going to be a little short from
my
vantage point. Yeah, he's going to be short. It's going to bring up fourth and one. Short one. Of course, they're going to have to go for it, being down 21 points.
This is a must need to get the first down here. Powell with Lovett next to him. Powell will get the first and five more yards.
Evan Powell and the quarterback keeper picked up by number four, Colin Wetterow.
That'll be the Shawnee 42-yard line. 10 minutes to go. Powell in. Lovett next to him. And a timeout.
We have
charged
a timeout
Cherokee.
Cherokee.
And that'll be their... And we'll like to take a moment here to thank the crew that has been broadcasting you to this game. This is Sean Conrad, Talon Loriello, Owen Volkrich, Kevin Slickmeyer, Zach Meyer, Jared Herman, Steven Minder, Matt Mathis, Evan Bradley, Samantha Goldstein, David Hamity, Michael Morosky, and Megan Schulthies, and with our sideline reporter, Alyssa Biederman, and Joe Melagrana, and me, Jimmy Freeze here. Thank you for joining us. We're here with 10 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. And Shawnee up 35-14. As Joe said earlier in the broadcast, not something that was expected here tonight, but Shawnee's been playing their heart out.
And
a flea flicker that's on the ground. It works.
We're lucky to,
completely against
Lucky
Jericho.
It wasn't a turnover there.
Flea flicker. Wow. Spoiled by number 69, David
Coach Megan really going into his bag of tricks here late in the game.
Loss of 8 on the play.
Pick up the flea flicker after Cherokee calls their first timeout. Each team with two left in the second half. On the second half, yes.
Powell back to throw. Big throw here. And
intercepted.
Might be intercepted by the Renegades. Terrific interception.
Colin Wetterow.
Colin Wetterow.
A sophomore.
Oh, there's a name from the past. His dad and his uncles went to Shawnee. Wow.
Take a look at that replay. Sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy. At the web at ivyrehab.com.
And Wetterow
coming from a long line of successful athletes, as you said, Joe.
Yep.
We'll get that replay to you as soon as we can. What a terrific. Wow. There's the first turnover of the game, Joe.
Yeah, and that was great positioning by Wetterow, and boy. Shawnee's back on the offense once again.
And we'll get that replay back to you in a little bit here. Make you think about that interception and how good that was.
Michael Wells will be quarterback keeper. Good for a gain
out of
8.
Nah.
And...
We're just having fun up here.
Always a good time here with Joe and Jim and the whole crew here at LDTV.
And some guy named DJ in the truck.
And some, yes.
the DJ, Giants fan.
DJ in the truck.
I'm not mentioning the Mets. Are you kidding me? Get out of here.
You see Mike Welsh in the shotgun. And looks like an injured Renegade, maybe. A little slow to get up. And he looks like he's, something's wrong with the ankle. Looks like an offensive lineman.
Maybe a cramp, he's pulling back on his upper toes, we'll see.
It is getting pretty cold out here.
The trainer's out there, and head trainer Kip Patterson and Stephanie Morose.
Terrific Shawnee training group. intend to purchase a copy of today's game?
No, we're going with fall playoffs.
Oh, well, fall playoffs are coming up. Check the LDTV Sports website for the complete schedule of playoff coverage at www.lrhsd.org/LDTV. And we'll tell you that front slash is a thing. We're going to tell you how to purchase a copy a little bit later.
Well, if
and it is later, and we're going to show you to purchase a copy of today's game. Please visit www.lrhsd.org/LDTV copies. Not front slash, not backslash, just slash.
Well, if you're right-handed, it's a front slash. If you're left-handed, it's a backslash.
There you go, Joe. Always having my back.
I got your back, buddy.
I appreciate it. As long as I have Italians having my back, that's all I care about.
I had your dad in class. I got your back, buddy. Ay, ay, ay. Okay, let's get back on track here.
And Mike Welsh here in the shotgun with Mikey Githens to his side. Hands it off. And Githens will get about 1 yard.
If any. Stop by number 44, Michael Pullen.
Michael Welsh, three wide receivers out to his sides with Mikey Githens on his right. Well, he's just eating away time here, and Welsh will keep it for a gain of about five. And let's take a look at that replay sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy and on the web at ivyrehab.com. And we're going to see the interception by Colin Wetterell to really just shut down Cherokee. And
that was just great positioning by Colin Wetterell and a great interception.
And there's Mike Welsh, 6:30 and running. 6:33 and running. Shawnee's not concerned about this time.
No, I know. I'm sure he's going to keep it on the ground most of the time here.
There's another run, and he'll just run it out of bounds, which will stop the clock, but it will not stop. No, it will stop.
Yeah, okay, run out of bounds, but moving the chains but anyway, though.
Keep his safety in check, so Shawnee's really worried about here. First down. 6:20 to go, first and 10 for the Renegades. Renegades up 35-14 here at Shawnee High School on a chilly Friday night. And we have to see where that forward progress lands them. Good spot for Shawnee.
It looks like a gain of four is going to be second and six. Coming down 6 minutes left.
Joe here with 5:40 to go. Shawnee just wants to make sure they hold the ball, which is huge, and just make sure nobody gets hurt. But
that's it, and knock some time off the clock. Yeah. We'll see where all the run plays.
Cherokee trying to strip the Renegades running backs are trained to have strong arms on the ball. And time will be running. Evan Powell with that tackle.
Brings up third and six.
Third and six for the Renegades. Mike Johnson comes in. That terrific catch earlier in the half and also a touchdown early in the game. Mike Welsh, quick pass to Anthony Magoo. And a nice play. Still fighting for that.
Unbelievable play.
Terrific play, not giving up. Anthony Magoo, who was a recipient of a touchdown pass from Mike Welsh earlier in the quarter, yes.
Wouldn't you think they were going to keep it on the ground? Coach Gushue calls a, you know, pass play. Little dance step over the defender, and Magoo picks up another first down.
Anthony Magoo is a verbal commit to William & Mary. And let's take a look at that replay. Sponsored by Ivy Rehab Physical Therapy and on the web at ivyrehab.com. Should be Anthony Magoo making a terrific play.
And I think we're live right here, and we'll catch it in a second. Let's see if this is it.
We'll see.
I think we're going to get the replay here.
Mike Welsh get the snap. Setup play. And we're back here live. It was second and two.
Now if we can get that play on a replay, I'd be great to share that again. Great effort by Anthony Magoo. A keeper.
Welsh with another keeper. Terrific play.
Faked the handoff inside and just kept it himself. Picks up another first down. Absolute fantastic game by number 44, Shawnee's quarterback, Michael Welsh.
Michael Welsh, who has a kind of a touchdown reception to himself after being hit from the defender, gets it back to himself. He can get a passing and receiving touchdown there for his fantasy points there. And it looks like a false start for Shawnee. Count gets the offensive line.
I don't think you'll see Coach Gushue calling a timeout, though. It's a 21-point lead. He's done that like three times tonight, and he didn't like what he saw, and he called the timeouts. And boy, they capitalized them on the next play or two after those timeouts.
There's Welsh to Magoo, who will dig it out and get about 2 yards with forward progress. Or maybe.
Yeah, throw was low on that, and they really couldn't get much momentum or to make a move to get loose. So they keep possession. Maybe a gain of a yard or loss. Yeah, just got back to the line of scrimmage, so it's still second and 15.
Second and 15 for the Renegades. And Welsh getting a call from his father. Hands it off to Githens. Githens, terrific run to get the first down. Barrels through. Another first down for Shawnee.
This time went right up the middle and plenty of room there. I'm sure that Cherokee defensive line is gassed at this particular point in time.
Michael Welsh on the Cherokee six. Welsh hands it off to Githens, looking for a touchdown, and
he's close.
Close. The referees say he's short.
Mike Githens on the carry down.
And it will eat away time.
A great second and third effort there. Looked like he was stopped, and one of the One of the tacklers on the Chiefs actually had him by the jersey, kept his legs moving, almost got the touchdown. And they can pick up a first down also.
And it looks like they're in the formation too.
I'll stand corrected. No, they cannot. It's second and goal on the one.
Look like they want to take a knee.
Yeah, they're probably not
going to. Prior knowledge.
They even take a penalty here.
There they are. Wow. We'll take a knee. May have to get one more play in. And they will have to get one more play in. Coaches from the sideline saying so. And
no, they're not.
Maybe not.
They're coming off. Yep.
There you have it right there, Joe. Unbelievable game from Shawnee, led by Michael Welsh. With four passing touchdowns. That's a final to tonight's game. And Cherokee, who is ranked number three.
35, Cherokee Chiefs 14.
So, and we see the final, Cherokee 14 and Shawnee 35. And we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we'll show you the player of the game and the play of the game.
Today's game on LDTV Sports, sponsored by Deborah Heart and Lung Center, where experience matters. 800-555-1990, www.deborah.org. Philadelphia Wholesale Produce Market. All the best, all right here. 215-336-3003. Or on the web at www.pwpm.net. Comegno Law Group, specializing in general and special education law, representing individuals, families, public boards of education, and independent schools. 888-313-IDEA or comegnolaw.com. Wilmore School of Gymnastics and Cheer, where every child is special. Located on Briggs Road in Mount Laurel, 856-234-5292. Medford Village Car Care, serving the area's car care needs for 30 years. Located at 11 North Main Street in Medford, 609-654-4023. And on the web at mvcc-nj.com. For information on how your business can become a sponsor of LDTV Sports, contact Joe Malagrana, LDTV Underwriting Manager, at 609-268-2000, extension 8680. Or by email, jmelagrana@lrhsd.org.
Back here at Shawnee, after a terrific win by Shawnee, and it's time for the Reconstructive Orthopedics Player of the Game. 1-800, for the play of the game. Time now to take a look at the All-State Good Hands Play of the Game, sponsored by Michael McDyer, CLTC, 609-654-1426, or Michael McDyer at allstate.com. Allstate, you're in good hands.
It'll be interesting to see which play it is.
Oh. And this is the Michael Welsh. Joe, I think we're going to see Michael Welsh
right back into him,
passing and receiving touchdown.
Of course, that has to be the play of the game.
That was absolutely terrific. Heads up, the whole team was on point tonight.
And who knows if that ball gets intercepted, we may have had a different game. You know, unbelievable.
Definitely a momentum booster there for Shawnee. Not many. Momentum boost for Cherokee tonight, sadly, but
certainly opened up the door for the Renegades, and they went through it many, many times. Just a great all-around job by the Shawnee Renegades. As you see the score there, 35-14. Cherokee comes in ranked 3, and with those power points that the Shawnee's going to pick up, that's going to increase their chances for a possible playoff position and also possibly into the top 15.
And we're going to take a quick break here. When we come back, we are going to see, we're going to talk to the player of the game. And thank you.
New page. Viewers can find a large variety of video content, including current and previous seasons of series such as We Teach and Where Are They Now, as well as LDTV's game show, Picture This. The page also features highlights from past and present LDTV awards, showcasing student video productions from around the district. You can also catch Lenape District varsity sports action with the latest LDTV sports broadcasts. Check out all the best shows, sports, and educational videos on LDTV's YouTube page at youtube.com/LenapeDistrictTV.
All right. And now it's time for the Reconstructive Orthopedics Player of the Game. 1-800-896-RECON. Or on the web at www.reconstructiveortho.com. Let's send it down to Alyssa, standing by for the interview.
Hi, guys. I'm here with Mike Welsh, who is our player of the game tonight. He is the one who had the deflected pass, which was our play of the game. Take us through that.
We got a cover zero look where everybody went man across. I tried to get the ball over the top of the D lineman. He deflected it. It kind of came back to me. I kind of speared it with one hand. I ran it in. It was a play of a lifetime. I don't think I've ever had something like that. And it was just an awesome momentum builder. And it was just great.
It really was. So you played against a district school tonight, and now you have the same exact game record. And you gained a couple of power points. So yes. How big of a win of this? What was it for Shawnee?
This was a huge win, just confidence-wise in our team. We have a really young team, and I'm really proud of these guys and how they handled themselves. We had some sophomore receivers step up big times. That a kid gets two touchdown passes, first touchdown, and I mean, it was a great, great game for us overall, and just a huge confidence builder. And of course, it helps with power points since they were such a highly ranked team. But it was just an awesome game.
All right, thanks. Congrats on your win. All right, back to you guys.
Thanks, Alyssa. And that's going to about wrap it up for me and Joe Melagrana and me, Jimmy Freeze, here for you. And thank you for viewing here, and we'll see you next time on LDTV. Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody.
This program was produced by Lenape District Television.
Do you have a plan to increase security in places like that?
The district has up-to-date and well-tested emergency response plans.